Yeah, okay, apocalypse. Joe then, yeah. Right. Now these are some interesting gods and combinations. Double posse with Kronos. With Zeus, Loki, and Ra. And frozen wastes. Well, I don't envy Earth all that much. But he did apparently spawn on flank, did he? I think he did. Yeah, he did. That's unfortunate. If he was in the pocket, it would be slightly better for him. But right now this is gonna be kinda unfortunate. Kinda unfortunate indeed. But overall the gods are of course quite interesting. Zeus, Poseidon, Loki, Kronos, Poseidon, Ra on frozen wastes. Quite a nice combination all around. Of course, quite nice hunt. This is gonna be exactly a staple for a map like this. And you can see the TC's in the middle. Kind of nice circle in there. No problem for either player. So curious how this is gonna be played out. We will be definitely expecting that. At least the Zeus is gonna be going for Lord of Centauri. This is gonna be in hands of GreenSeaSquash. So definitely very dangerous indeed, especially if he is a pocket player. So a combination of centaurs with booming, I think it's gonna be coming into play. And it might be really kinda nasty. Though that said, he might have to help Earth a bit, I'm expecting. As PiscoWorldEater on the right side, who is apparently supposed to be Joe, if we are to trust Apocalypse, which I hope that we can. And apparently, yeah, go fast, Bass. They do hips and double firmer. Well, yeah, maybe. Maybe. But I'm really curious what Earth is gonna do. Because I'm thinking he might be better off going one TC faster heroic than actually 2 TC. This is gonna be wide open map and they are gonna be definitely coming for them quite fast. Poseidon, that's gonna be full in hips. Maybe a few centaurs, maybe. Gonna be a question if he actually makes like one extra or something like that. On dry, this is gonna be Kronos for Odinkin and he's again. This actually a repeat from the last game. Okay, let's see if he's gonna be doing the same. He's gonna be doing the same right about now against Pisco. Definitely curious because it could be maybe working again if his opponent is not all that ready for that. And Shelty is in the pocket, gonna be coming of course for the early game as well. And well, yeah, I really don't know who it is. I haven't checked anything, so I'm just right now going off your word, Apocalypse. So maybe if it's not him, then it's not gonna be him. Doesn't really matter. It's gonna be probably some kind of good player, and it seems like they actually, at least some of them know who it is. So I will be assuming it's gonna be someone good. Maybe I'm completely wrong, maybe not. You're gonna be learning a bit later, of course. But so far we haven't seen any kind of notification what it could be and who it could be and whatever like that. So let's for example look at the gold positions. Very nice for Fox. You can see guarded by the trees at the very backside in there. So apparently Shelty is having a lot of laughing in there. So maybe they are having some kind of... they are talking maybe through Discord or something like that. Not really impossible, as he's scouting behind his base, and overall the bases have been scouted really quite well at this point. Shelty apparently right now not happy with the hunt or something like that, I would be expecting. He's gonna be luring one of the caribous right next to his base, right next to his TC, and also taking a bit of extra ones from the right side, and quite plenty of them actually. Scavenging the one in the middle, and... Yeah, apparently Shelty having a bit of fun with his allies, but we don't really know the other side of the conversation in here. Bit of scouting, of course, by Odinkin, so that he has an idea about Pisco. There was a bit of flaring, of course. Didn't see the color, unfortunately. But I think it was actually Pisco who noticed them. Especially since he is coming right there with the Ulfsark and are on top of him, trying to destroy this little scout, so that he cannot get all that easily there, Odinkin. Kinda curious if he's gonna be attempting also to go back, or rather somewhere to the backside, with the temple and stuff like that, because it could be maybe potentially dangerous against GreenSeaSquash. And ooh, well, there we go. No centaur raiding. Absolutely no centaur raiding. This is gonna be an aggressive play with Athena. So are they like gonna Athena rush against the Kronos? That seems like a valid possibility. That seems like a valid possibility indeed. You can see Forseti temple inside his base, and he needs to basically make sure that this temple is not discovered at the advanced time. So maybe he could have wanted to actually build it somewhere to the back. Oh, he already did. Scratch that. He's already building a second one. So right now if Odinkin does get one, it's gonna be of course slowing down Pisco. That's absolutely no question about that. It is a nuisance for Loki nonetheless. But the biggest problem would be if he didn't get the free mythical unit. Right now he's gonna be completely safe. Yep, no problem whatsoever. As this dude is definitely coming back so that he can transport his temple and maybe really find the temple there of his opponent, so that he can deconstruct it a bit later. So Athena coming forward, what the other ages are gonna be. Hermes, Bast, Forseti, Prometheus. Okay. Okay. So far, kind of standard, not really any kind of problem. But the Bast is interesting. The Bast is interesting, of course, here, because it's gonna be resulting into some attack with mythical units. But that's what they have said at the very start, anyway. So that's the reason for that, why they are coming for such a weird god power, or rather such a weird. It's not really that weird. You see them use it relatively often lately. It's not really a staple anymore that you need to go Ptah Azera. As the relic for better village gold gather rate, pretty sweet. And before we get into the battles, let's check the other ones as well. Titan's Treasure, pretty good one. If you can actually pass it along the team, that's quite a nice saving of 75% basically across your team on all of those. All of those Titan Gates. That's of course right now raiding, and this is exactly the reason for the Bast. Not only the Eclipse, but also the Sphinxes, which are really good for the raiding, because they are quite fast, they do have quite a solid attack, and the special attack especially is really good. Really good indeed. So yeah, this is gonna be a bit of a nuisance for Fox. He will have to right now play a bit better, and maybe move somewhere. Where is he actually going? For the TC, I'm guessing. Yeah, he's definitely going for the TC at this point. With gold release in there, so he's gonna be reasonably slow in going. So he's definitely not gonna be coming for the centaurs though, because of course he's a Poseidon, so he doesn't have all that much favor. And what is the plan then? Because without any kind of gold whatsoever, he's gonna be damn slow in the Hippicons a bit later. So it's kind of questionable choice for him to be coming with gold villages in there. You can see the difference from Shelty. Shelty is still having gold release. Usually when you are as a Zeus or as any kind of Greek coming for a TC, you're using foodies. Because usually the other resources you are not gathering all that much. You are having like 4 or 5 villages on gold and wood, and you cannot really afford to send them anywhere else. So I think really this is going to be resulting into not a good game for Fox, even though he's coming even for 30 C right off the bat. Man! Now that is interesting, but 2 ceasefires from Shelty and Fox, that might be working, but still it's kind of interesting. They're definitely going to have to use one right about now. Without any kind of question whatsoever. Maybe he could be actually using Eclipse to save it. Or rather to prevent it. I'm kind of thinking he maybe could have done it. And should have done it. Since he didn't see the insta ceasefire, he could have attempted it. He could have been way stronger. And this TC just wouldn't have come up. But anyway, he didn't do so. In the middle, GreenSeaSquash is already at 2 TCs. And producing, of course, the hoplites in the middle. It seems like that might be the only army, which is not such a stupid thought, because considering he's against two Poseidons, it's gonna be inevitably meaning, like, basically only Hippicons for at least the start of the game. And maybe the other units are gonna be coming in a bit later. But still, this is a solid idea, solid start, and he's probably gonna be way into heroic before he needs to switch into some other type of unit. At the top side, there is, of course, a bit of a respite of the fight between Odinkin and Pisco. You can see that Pisco is playing rather well and quite defensively, as he's not really wanting to be surprised anywhere with a few raiders at the back of the opponent's bases. And well, of course, with the DC being finished, Wallin kinda getting finished as well. You're gonna be waiting what kind of extra units are gonna be made. Well, obviously, Hippicons, but the economies are not exactly great. Rather, it's not exactly great for Red, as he's out of gold completely. So from what exactly do you expect to be making the Hippicons? That is the real question here. Like, is he like programmatically not gathering gold? I think that something went wrong actually for Fox in the process. Because he's so far absolutely not getting gold. This is really not good for him. He's gonna be opening quite a bit of opportunity for Air to basically do whatever he wants, because so far he wasn't attacked at all. As opposed to, for example, Pisco at the top side, who is having kind of hard time defending against all of this, losing one of the temples in there. As he maybe was thinking that, well, not really. I was just having a thought. Maybe he was thinking that he's advancing, but there's still the second temple, and he did have no chance of destroying that either. So, no, that wasn't because of the advance time. It was just basically because he wanted to be annoying and slow his opponent as much as he can. Okay, Earth right now gonna be at 3 TCs, and he's gonna be given basically all the time for that by Fox. And I think it's kind of non-tactical, untactical, or how to call it. You can see even Hierarchos Sphinx already. No, only Cryo Sphinx. Hierarchos Sphinx could be coming a bit later. But of course, Draven still going on. Only a few villages right now coming for the gold finally, with pickaxe being there, but that's all the upgrades that he's so far having. And plenty of villages in the middle, so potentially even Odinkin could be losing a few if he was under attacking there. In the meantime, it seems like that Shelty is gonna be on my way to the left, to the scouting of all those, and raiding, of course, of the Cryo Sphinxes. As we have also seen on the right, quite a solid attack of the teal player, but unfortunately for him, GreenSeaSquash is right now recognizing the opportunity that he can be helping his teammate, and he probably even should, so that he is stabilized a bit, gets into the heroic cage, and really gets on his feet, because it seems like it so far, Odinkin is doing rather well, and would be yet again beating his opponent as he did in the last game. So yeah, let's see if it's gonna be the correct choice here. Maybe they learned from the last game quite a bit. Now, as the hoplites are unupgraded, but I will be at this point then expecting that maybe some ages are gonna be coming up, but apparently not. And he's getting relic for, Thundercloud Shawl for better pierce armor. That's actually quite important. That's actually quite important for the hoplites, and not only for them. But anyway, there was of course armory being moved by Odinkin to block a path of the hoplites, I'm thinking, because he wanted to catch them and destroy them fully, as the sphinxes are basically doing what they do the best, and that is raiding and killing villages. Can see one dead right now, quickly decomposing into the snow. As on the left side, Fox is just doing what he can right now to boom, and he still doesn't have really... This is really strange on the left side. Completely strange. Oh, is he gonna notice? He should. Oh, he didn't. Oh, he did. The very last moment he did, actually. So he's gonna be at least getting a few, maybe with a bit of help of Pisco. Oh yeah, this is quite nicely done. Quite nice blockage, so all of those villages are pretty much toast. Maybe one is gonna survive, that's gonna be it. Very well done right about now by the bottom team. As to basically finish my thought on that, Earth and Shelty are pretty much not doing, or rather Earth and Fox, are pretty much not doing anything at this point at all. But I think that's an advantage for Earth, because once he gets going as an Egyptian, I think as a Poseidon, Fox on Titans has limited chances. I mean, like, Poseidon is not bad, but I legit think it's a risk against someone like Ra. Against other gods, probably not that much. But against Ra, I think this is really gonna be a risk, especially with all the raiding and all the inaccuracies in the economy that Fox did have before. Right now, Hyperion and Segment coming forward, yeah. The Heroic Age is already in. We're gonna be expecting Heroic Age, I'm thinking, from the red player as well. You can see Masons coming forward. And Aphrodite as well, yep, as we expected. But with the Migrol maybe being dropped somewhere close by, yep, exactly for him. He will probably have to drop one also to the left a bit, as he's coming on the secondary gold. And there are plenty of golds here also, as GreenSeaSquash is scouting all of them and hoping that it might be enough. So there we go, this is gonna be the Eclipse to destroy everything that he can, like for example a few militias and buildings. But in the front he's going definitely right now for the Scarab, so that he can prevent the ceasefire. This is a combination of both Helbis units, but mainly to prevent the ceasefire from his opponents, because right now it seems like that actually GreenSeaSquash thought that this is gonna be much easier. Yeah, well, he definitely thought it's gonna be much easier, and it's not. But with right now, the Theseus getting skewered in there. Oh, yeah. It's gonna be getting skewered quite significantly, and Scarab is surviving. Those dudes are gonna be just enough to put the DC down for Fox. And since Fox doesn't have any kind of army yet, you can see just a few medium Hippicons now. It doesn't seem that well going for the team to the top side. Aphrodite for Shelty, and he cannot cast Aphrodite. Couldn't cast it to basically help him even more. But I don't think he would have cast it all that much. He probably just would have ceasefired it. But maybe it was just like one for one, because at the same time, if he cast the curse to be like 6-7 units gone maybe, and that might have been enough, especially if he targeted all the hoplites. But yeah, well, that's gonna be just a maybe at this point, as we are heading back to the right side, where still Odinkin is having a good game against Pisco, but it almost seems like that it might be just turning. As there we go, as he is trying to take the TC, is it gonna be second ceasefire we cast by Shelty? That is a big question at this point, as there are still plenty of TCs free, and they might be kinda abused, especially by the Norse. So I'm thinking that Pisco might be having the opportunity to maybe steal a TC. Oh, he definitely does have the resources for that. You can see he's even a house. But right now, this is gonna be ceasefire, and let's see him switch into, for example, the TC there. Yep, there we go. He's right now gonna be exactly heading for the town center, because the villages are far away. Maybe gonna be able to get a TC in the front as well in the meantime. Now this is just basically absolutely certainly at the last, or rather at the first second and first thought that he's gonna be doing. He is there, as he's gonna be right now. Pretty big problem for Odinkin, because at this point, Earthquake coming for Earth? Against Earth. That is definitely a possibility, and it's gonna be a double Earthquake, but it's not coming yet. First it's gonna be Apollo from GreenSeaSquash, as he's going for a lot of raiding with the hoplite still. But that Heroic Cage, of course, with the Underworld Passage, is gonna be one hell of a nuisance for the opponents coming from about here. Where is he having all the army? All about here. All the way to the back, I'm expecting trying to reach Shelty. I'm thinking he's gonna be coming onto Shelty, because on the left side, I really think that Earth is having the game quite well in hand so far against Fox, and he shouldn't be having all that much of a problem, though. Is he? Well, he's right now going for a lot of radiant, of course, with all the chariot archers, and what I'm certainly missing at this point. Oh well, is he gonna get stopped? Fortunately, Odinkin wasn't fast enough. So yep, even a few settlers coming forward with the army coming there in pretty huge numbers. Yep, gonna push GS's hard. Huh. Well, he definitely has to hope that it's hard enough, because at this point, even with all of those Murmillos, since they are not all that upgraded, you can see, and the Heresiers are, or are they not? Well, they are kinda not as well, or rather either. Maybe some kind of melee shield would be good, but against all those mythic units, Odinkin is gonna be completely naked, and you can see how he's losing significantly, those myth units completely owning him. But let's switch to the middle, where Shield is proclaiming that he's gonna destroy right now GreenSeaSquash, and it's not all that impossible, but already heavy hoplites. Heavy hoplites with the extra relic, that's definitely helpful. Against medium Toxotai, well, yeah, well, not that much, but against Hippogons, at least slightly. And they are gonna be able to actually stop this quite in full. But he probably will need a bit of assistance, because he's kinda all over the place. You can see, he's even right now losing. He's right now even losing the base DC in there due to the radiant from GreenSeaSquash. And that was very well played, because right now Odinkin is gonna be losing everything. He's gonna be down to 0 TCs, and GreenSeaSquash can just do and go wherever he wants, because at this point you can just expect Pisco to handle the situation quite confidently, as there is a lot of raiding going on by Earth on the left, who is buying in basically all the army of his opponent, or like half of the army, even right now getting into solid raiding on the gold on the left side. Very well played, as in the middle it doesn't seem all that promising for Shelty yet, though. This fortress is kinda scary, but of course the hoplites, especially since they are very nicely upgraded for GreenSeaSquash, they're gonna be able to get rid of this in no time. But yeah, of course, militias are gonna be following fairly quickly, as Fox is through Artemis, and that might be cast somewhere here. Or no, he's going for his opponent, and that is definitely the correct decision. Destroying all the military buildings, this is why you need to be careful. Especially since Earth basically said that earthquake is coming. I hope he did rebuild some military buildings somewhere else. No, he didn't. Yeah, then that's another fail. That's an utter fail, because if you are expecting earthquake, you just need to be having distributed military buildings to basically avoid this problem, because right now he's kind of screwed. He's still gonna be, I think, reasonably popped, so he's lucky in that. He's missing a house, I think. Seems to be missing a house, or no, that's just the citadel. In which case, what's going on? He should be having 160, shouldn't he? Yeah, he's missing a few houses. He's having 45 TC, he's not 160, and he does have citadel. He's missing a few houses and he doesn't realize it. Maybe he'll sit in the earthquake right now? I don't think so, though. Quite nice cooperation with the reconstruction coming forward as well. And this could be a bit of a turning moment, because Fox will be having an upper hand. And he might be able to even take this TC down as well. He might be taking down the TC as well. The Scarab's kind of nice idea, but they're probably not gonna be strong enough. Now let's see if... yeah, there's gonna be at least the Chimera Tyrant, or rather, wannabe Tyrant, only normal Chimera, but of course with the Zeus and a few more extra heroes maybe coming forward as well, he should be able to defend, but question is if the top side is gonna be finished, because this time it seems that PiscoWorldEater together with, of course, GreenSeaSquash as well, they are completely destroying them, as Shelty is losing a back TC in there. Of course, Odinkin, we have seen, is pretty much dead already way before, and all the TCs being captured by Pisco, he is gonna be controlling the map in there quite significantly, and they are basically just pushing into Shelty so that he cannot do anything else. He has already lost all the buildings in the middle, and yep, all the army right now from GreenSeaSquash coming into the backside of Fox to save the teammate Earth, and it seems that Earth maybe doesn't even need the saving, as, wow, he was able to save the town center. God damn it. Did not expect that at all. That was looking so much a goner. But apparently not. And well played. And Earth would be probably able to handle the situation just by himself, as Odinkin is at this point gone. Well, of course, he was gone from the game a bit before. As Shelty is gonna be following up, because he's, of course, also being worked upon and massaged by GreenSeaSquash, with, of course, PiscoWorldEater significantly, as this is gonna be Fox's last man standing, with the TC coming down. Just exactly the correct timing. Well timed, Fox. Good timing. Exactly on the millisecond when it was coming down, he resigned. I think he might have been even waiting for that. Just for a bit of fun. But it was a nice game. It was a really nice game indeed. Quite well played. The early game actually looked quite bad for Pisco. It seemed like that Odinkin should be beating him. Odinkin really plays Kronos quite well. But the timely help from GreenSeaSquash Definitely saved him. Definitely saved him. And overall, on the left side, I just didn't understand what was actually Fox's plan. Because he was playing Poseidon as if he were playing some kind of Eggie. He really was. Getting the TCs, going for the economy. He was probably maybe even lulled a bit by the fact that he's against Earth. And on such a map, he's gonna be kind of passive. So he thought he's having enough time, but yeah. The more time you give him, obviously, the harder it's gonna be. Whatever got you're gonna be playing, you just... yeah. Yeah, well. Anyway, let's go into postgame. This is very, very nice. I'm kind of liking actually Express playing various gods, even though they don't know all that much. And that is... the fun of Age of Mythology. So GreenSeaSquash deserved. He was really important in the game. And from the opponents, I really like Odinkin how played. And Shelty wasn't bad either, but Odinkin was standout player, definitely. Yeah, the military count 130 against 75. He was going quite heavy into the Toxotai, but he was countering basically all the hoplites from the opponent, so yeah, it's understandable. But apparently it wasn't the correct recipe in the end. Oh yeah, this is where it went just completely sour for Odinkin. Okay, GG.